No! And go all the way through.
I am Jen Miles with the Sheriff's Office, and today we're working on some self-defense moves. One of the things that we do is what's called a hammer fist. This is going to be my target area. A hammer fist is used if somebody were to grab you. If he grabbed my wrist, I want to target his forearm. What this does is it hits a sensitive spot in the arm, therefore opening the hand, even if it's just slightly, enough where I can pull my arm out and be able to get away. A hammer fist is made by curling your fingers down, bringing your thumbs over your fingers. The flat part of your hand is used to make contact with the sentry area or your target area. I'm going to bring my hammer all the way up. No! And go all the way through. The other thing that I expressed was that I didn't want him by me. I wanted to make sure that if there's anyone out there who sees what's going on, that they understand that this is not a wanted situation. I want him to get away from me, and I want to be able to run away. It's a really simple technique. It's brought literally by bringing the arm above the head, elbow towards the sky as much as possible, and you bring it down and all the way through your target, bring it all the way back. So you want that full and complete follow through on this move. The target area is right within the forearm here. Kind of makes your hand open up. And it's a really simple technique if you want to come and join me. So if he goes to grab your wrist, you're going to curl your hand into a fist, bring your elbow all the way up above your head, and you're going to focus on that.
Okay.
Bring your body all the way down and through, literally dropping all your body weight into it.
Okay?
Whenever you're ready.
Oh, good. That did not hit you in the right spot.
Well, you got your target, but you want to remember to pull that arm away at the
pull
same
arm
time.
Away. Okay.
Because you don't want him to hold on.
Oh, yeah. I just had to let that arm there, didn't I?
No.
Okay.
So bring it down all the way through. Good.
Oh,
and then make sure you follow all the way through your, all the way to the back. Okay? Because we're a lot stronger when we follow all the way through. Like a baseball player, they don't stop at all. All
right.
So
we're doing the
same thing.
All right.
Sure. One more time.
All right.
And if you give a good shout, you're going to be even stronger. There you go. There you go. Good job. One of the things that you can follow this technique up with is if he bends over, which he slightly did, is a really good knee strike. Knee strike has two main targets on somebody who wants to come after you to rape you, kill you, or try and steal you. All right? By grabbing the head and driving that into the knee, you do a lot of damage to the face. Okay? If you can't quite have that target, then you go for the groin and you want to force everything up. Do you like a bigger pad for this one?
So you get knocked in the face by my knee.
So I'm actually going to grab his wrist to do this
because
part of this technique is securing the bad guy. We don't want him to try and run away from this technique. All right? So I'm going to grab him. My foot is far back, and I'm going to bring the knee all the way down and then up and through my target. All right? So, no! Again, I don't want him by me. I want to make sure he knows that. So it's going up and through the target. Alright, so here, up and all the way in. See how it's a little bit less without that voice?
Now what if he's like holding you like this, but you're holding him like this if he does something like this?
Go after the inside of the knee.
Okay. With what?
Your knee. If you go after the inside of his knee with your knee, you drive that in, what's going to happen to him? It's going to buckle. That knee does not go side to side very well.
For your life?
Exactly. Exactly. The classes are built around making sure that we're protecting our consciousness, which is literally breathing. So you gotta grab a hold of his wrist nice and tight. You know, bring whichever foot you feel comfortable with back.
Yep.
And just bring it up and through. Loud enough.
Like that?
Yeah, we don't wanna rock at them. So you gotta really think about it, right? Oh no. The follow-up with that is that heel through the top of the foot.
Okay.
Right? If you have those shoes on, you're not going to have a chance to be like, hey, hold on, bad guy, let me take these off. Okay? And it will. Exactly. Yep. Yep.
And then
all the way up and through. No! Good. And
it's fine.
Go right at it.
No.
Good. And this is.
That would not scare anybody away.
He's still going to think about it, though. When you're pulling into him, no! It's going up and through. With this, you kind of have to stop your momentum because you don't want to fall on top of it.
Yeah.
But when it's a bad guy, you're going right through.
Okay.
You're driving everything you have from all the way, literally your feet, all the way up and through.
Okay. That's
pretty easy technique, though.
Yeah.
Even if it's light. Even if it's light, it's a pretty easy technique. So a hammer fist can go down. What would our targets be? Face, throat, right? Hammer fist to the throat.
What about like the ears?
Probably not enough damage. This is life or death for you,
okay.
So we want to make this so he remembers. We don't like it.
Okay.
So we're going to deliver a hammer fist to the face, to the throat. Hammer fist can go up, groin, grab, twist, pull. Oh, it's good if you can get the throat.
Okay.
But even the bottom of the chin, probably not as much. If he's on something, whether it's alcohol or drugs or anything like that, probably not as much damage. Knee strikes to the inside of the knee, the groin, the face if you have it, great target. So those are a couple of the moves that we learn on our Saturday classes, and they're really simple. A lot of the foundation is built around our voice, so really built around verbalizing that we don't want screaming. The bag here. Not screaming, not just like arbitrary screaming, but intentional, no, get away from me, stay away. Something so you can make good witnesses. If I have somebody out there who says, yeah, that girl just went crazy on him, right?
Yeah.
And that's what people will say if they only see you doing stuff and the bad guy's like, I don't know what she's doing.
Yeah.
But we want to know that that's the bad guy, you're the good guy, and this is your life. Classes are on Saturdays in October. They're from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m., and it's a four-hour class. If you go to oaklandsheriff.com, you can find out additional information there.